Yo, welcome to Sprawl and Brawl. It is episode number 36. Or is it 37? Dang, it's 37. It's episode number 37. I also screwed up last week and had it one number behind. So now, let's settle it. While Matt right here, it's episode number 37 right now. It's actually happening. This is the real 37. There's no screwing around. We're at 37. Next one's 38. Steiner.
Okay.
Okay, cool.
If you say so, I don't keep count. That's your job.
Yes, the next one is 38. Indeed. So, hey, this is a show about MMA, UFC, World Series of Fighting. Whenever they don't screw up is when we like to bring them up, preferably. But, you know, they screw up pretty often. You know. Bellator, all that good stuff. One championship. Oh, anything. Anything that happens. There's a lot of stuff on Fight Pass nowadays, too. So, Nothing this weekend, funny enough, except for that one UFC. There's nothing. That's it. That was the one event that was happening this weekend. Megascorcher.com, Megascorcher.com. Go check that website out. VODs, MP3s of this show available there. Available on our YouTube, which is Megascorcher TV. Like and subscribe. Check out iTunes for our podcast, video and audio form, or wherever you can find podcasts as well on your Android device or wherever else you do it. So, yeah, that's the intro. Let's go straight into the news this week. There's some stuff that happened this week. There was an event, but except for that, there's a lot of news too. So, something that we neglected to bring up last week, though, Lawler left American Top Team for some reason. Never really clarified or nothing's been said too much about it so far. They did have.
I would assume he just feels that he's in a rut and he needs to go to a different camp. Sure.
I forget who it was. He was on the MMA Hour as a teammate or a former teammate. He said miscommunication or something. I forget what he said. I don't know. It's weird. But yeah, hey, Lawler. I don't even know what he's doing anymore right now. He lost, one or two fights now?
One. He just lost the one. He hasn't fought since getting knocked out.
Okay. All right.
He was going to take a fight against Cerrone, but then he decided not to, just to give more time to heal from the knockout. he got punched really, really hard by Woodley, so taking some time off is a good idea.
Yes. But hey, it would have been the battle of the two guys who got knocked the fuck out.
But wait, what?
Because didn't Cerrone lose the fight before? Even because I think Cerrone got knocked out his two last fights, didn't he?
Donald Cerrone just got knocked out his last fight.
What about the one before that one?
He knocked out Matt Brown before that.
Mm. Okay then.
Which he fought Matt Brown, was a really good fight, and then took another fight like 5 weeks later and was not physically ready. And what happened is he got knocked the fuck out because he just did not look right from the very beginning. So I'm sure it was that he wasn't fully recovered.
So David Branch, he was a multiple World Series of Fighting champion. He was middleweight and light heavyweight. He's now gone. He's leaving. He's going to be a free agent, test the waters. I don't know if he could be in the UFC. He used to be, so could it happen? Sure. But I don't know, whatever. He's okay.
There's so many fighters. The point that he was middleweight and light heavyweight indicates to me just World Series of Fighting is...
Well, I think they lost... what's the other? Justin Gaethje left too. So that's three champions.
Yeah.
Three championship belts without a champion right now. Cool. Yeah, World Series of Fighting was go. Like I said this, the last event in New York was awesome, but at what cost? They canceled like two cards or something like that to fucking stack that one card.
Yeah.
So they only had like one event in the last like 4 months of the year in 2016 at the end. So. Yeah, I that's cool. And then their first event this year got canceled too. Supposed to take place February 17th. Does that make sense? Let me look at the calendar here. Oh, maybe it was this weekend. Oh, 17 is next Friday. Yeah, it would have been 17 or 18, maybe. It was this month. They only had one fight announced for that a card. It was in like New York, New Jersey, I think, is where they were going to have it too. Anyways, Eduardo Dantas versus Darion Caldwell is set for Bellator 177 in Budapest. That will also feature Bellator Kickboxing 3, or is it 6? Was it 3 that was in Budapest the first time? And then, anyways, whatever. Bellator Kickboxing, it exists.
I barely know.
They don't really show the kickboxing too much. If this is not live, I don't even know if they'll show it. I don't know because I remember the last time they had a kickboxing event right after, and it was kind of fucked up the timing that they showed it, so I didn't watch it. Normally, if it would have just been right after Bellator or before, I would have watched it, but there's something weird the last time that I just didn't end up watching it. I wish they still had Lori. Like, it sucks that they got rid of Lori and then. Let's make up our own. Let's get rid of these guys. Spike TV likes to do that now, though, with everything. They got their own MMA company. You know, they don't need to pay the rights or anything. They own it.
Yeah.
So it works out better for them, I suppose. Man, there's a dog barking outside, just going crazy. It's been going at it for a while. Anyways, DC said that Rumble will quit in their fight.
No, I don't. He does it all the time. That means.
Well, he said he does it all the time, man. He quits every fight, dude.
Well, he was submitted in their first fight, so he then technically.
Well, if I quit, I think he means like slow down and not be as awesome in the later rounds, and just slowly be grinded down.
Okay.
We'll see how this fight goes. We'll see.
Yeah. Or you can get punched in the head again and he doesn't blow his load on your face.
We'll see. Whoever wins is going to fight John Jones and lose anyways. So, well, then maybe not Rumble. Rumble might have a chance. DC might have a chance now because fucking Jones is... He didn't look that great in his last fight. And he has a lot of shit. He has a lot of shit to deal with.
Yeah, well, that's true. But he didn't look bad against Ovin St. Prude. He didn't look good against Ovin St. Prude. It just looked like he could have easily finished St. Prude, and he just never went for it.
Yeah, sure.
And he even knew that and said that after the fight. But
sure. He did not look like John Jones.
No. But again, he also didn't do a half a kilo of crack or cocaine or whatever the week.
Yeah, I don't think he does that before. Well, okay, a week.
No, he did it. He that was something he typically did 2 weeks before the fight. He went out and did a whole shit ton of blow and went out off and fucked a couple of bitches or something. I have no idea what exactly, but he used to go out partying 2 weeks before, and then he loosened him up, made him fight better, so he said. Because that was the first fight that he didn't do that for like 3 or 4 years, and look at what happened.
I know, that's why I do it. I don't do that stuff. No hard stuff, just alcohol. That's called Tuborg for some reason from Copenhagen. It's actually pretty good. I only got it because it was cheap. It was on sale at LCBO. Because we got to get our liquor through the government here. Is it in Alberta?
Well, is LCBO still technically government? Because I thought they sold LCBO.
Oh, fuck. The government might have sold it. I don't know. They sell everything nowadays.
It's... Government, how would it be? Like, so there's liquor stores that have different names. So, like, you have a Sobeys Liquor and you have a Liquor Depot or whatever.
In Ottawa now, you can have beer in
grocery stores,
yeah.
But the pricing is still fixed by the government. So,
yes.
It's not like down in the States, you can go, they can charge whatever the fuck they want.
Oh, dude,
it's not government regulated.
Do you know what Shock Top is?
I've heard of it before, yeah.
So when I went to the States, there was literally a tall boy for $1.
Yeah.
$1? That was insane. Everything else is like $2.
It'd be $1.30 Canadian.
Oh, what? A Shock Top? No, it's like $2 in Ontario.
No, but I mean, like, if you're converting that into Canadian dollars, it would be $1.30.
Oh, yeah, sure. That's still cheap as shit.
Yeah.
For a beer,
it also depends on what state you're in, because most of the states just You can sell.
I think I was in Maine, but I don't remember.
Yeah, that sounds about right. I mean, I'm high, like New York and like the larger states, New York, Texas, and California would typically are the ones that tax shit like that.
I was either in Vermont, Maine, or I was maybe I was maybe in Vermont actually. Yeah.
Same shit, different bile.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I wish I lived slightly closer to the states because I would go to the states to buy booze all the time.
About Quebec? Quebec would be.
Quebec is it's still expensive. It's not as cheap as people make it out to be.
It's cheaper than Ontario.
It's cheaper. Yes. Is it worth it to go there every time I want to get booze? Nah, not really. Because I have an LCBO and a beer store right there. It's literally, yeah. I can walk there. I don't even need to use the van if I don't want to. But it's super cold today, so I use the van. Yeah. All right. Edgar has
one more fight left on his deal. He wants to fight Max Holloway or Ricardo Lamas.
Mm-hmm. He was on the MMA Hour saying this.
I would probably have to say Lamas and Edgar sounds about right. Sounds good.
Yeah.
Holloway, not so much. Edgar lost his last fight. Or no, he didn't. He won against... what was his name? Stevenson. Jeremy Stevenson.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Sure, yeah. That seems to make sense in my mind.
I can see him fighting
Holloway, and then Holloway beats him and then gets the title.
Well, that's the thing. I just see Holloway beating the shit out of him.
Mm-hmm. Beating the shit? I don't know. Beating him up? Yes. I don't know if he'll actually kill him.
I don't like Holloway. Like, his counter wrestling is really good. I don't think he could hold him down. And then on the feet, the distance is just utterly stupid.
Oh, yeah, especially against Edgar, yes.
Edgar has, like, no, he's a dinosaur. He's like Sarah. He's not, like, he's fast on his feet or whatever, but his reach is jack shit. Like, Holloway is, like, fucking, like, Gumby or something. Like, he can just fucking stretch out like a, but, so I just think he'd just do a stiff jab to him and just break his nose and then beat the fuck out of when he collapses after he breaks his nose.
Mm-hmm.
But Lamas makes sense to me. But
whatever. We'll see what happens. Imagine if Edgar goes to Bellator. Jesus.
That'd probably actually be good.
Yeah. Yeah. Why not? Because Edgar
Does Bellator even have a 45?
I want to say they have all the divisions UFC has.
Okay.
The lower end. I want to say they have a lot of smaller guys in Bellator.
Okay. The
thing about Edgar is if you get him and you go to New York with a Bellator card, that's going to do pretty good.
Well, he's from Jersey, not New York.
Well, New Jersey, New York. It's right there.
I would like to see Holloway go up against Aldo or try to convince McGregor. And if that's at 45 or 55, I don't really care. I just want to see a rematch between those two.
Mm-hmm. All right. Jacare Souza doesn't believe that Rockhold is actually injured. And Tim Boach is actually fighting Souza on his last fight on his contract. So he's done. Sorry.
Souza or Boach?
Boach is on his last fight.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, dude, if he beats him and he's on his last fucking...
Then he goes to Bellator.
Oh, yeah. Like, that. Like, I just beat your number two guy. Theoretically, you're probably number two because I don't see Romero's just going to fucking beat the fuck out of everyone. I don't know. That guy's just fucking juiced to the fucking...
Yes. Who's the champion of that division right now? It's...
Bisping.
Oh, yeah. Oh, Jesus.
Yes.
Yep.
Yeah, so, well, Romero is just like, dude, that guy is like fucking Olympic. Like, did he win a silver or gold? I think he won the gold.
I wish I remember.
Soldier of God. training.
We're talking about Romero, right?
Yeah.
He's the No Forgay Jesus, right? That's him?
Yes.
Oh, yeah. Yes. Okay. Yeah. Romero. Okay. So he's juiced to the gills, but he's also ridiculously awesome.
Yeah. Yeah.
He's an awesome fighter. He's an awesome human being. I could listen to that guy talk all day in his broken English.
So he won silver in Olympic freestyle.
In his Cuban broken English.
Yeah. So it was a silver medal. I do think he won gold in the Pan Am Games, but in the Olympics he won silver.
Mm-hmm.
So he's like one of the best wrestlers on the planet, and the guy can go from 0 to 200 in half a second. So it's
and like whatever he did to look like that right now, he can maintain it without or he whatever he's doing, yeah. He's getting by.
Yes. But what he did to Weidman, he cracked Weidman's skull with that knee.
And Weidman's never really looked the same since then.
Well, it just happened.
Well, okay.
Weidman's fighting again soon.
I guess so.
He hasn't fought since, which I don't think he should be fighting this soon. Like that, I'm sure that cracked his fucking skull. Literally cracked his, I'm sure that fractured his skull, yet he's fighting in 2 weeks or 3 weeks.
Okay, I guess I meant since Luke Rockhold, he's never looked the same.
Oh, okay, yeah. Which then he got his, I think he got his face beaten and cracked and a couple of there too, but.
It's weird. Some New York dudes, they just lose one fight and it's just they're done.
So why is that 210? And that's in April, so it's a little.
It's not too long from now.
No. But it's a little further than I thought it was.
He's probably starting training really hard in two weeks, maybe a week from now. About a week. Yeah, maybe two weeks from now. He's going to start putting in the full camp.
2, 3, 4, 5.
He's training right now.
But 8 weeks, so it'd be this weekend would be his peak. You'd go to try to start his peak.
Mm-hmm.
Or doing his shit, so he peaks on the 8th of April.
Who was it? Anderson Silva was in the news this week, and he was like, "I'm gonna fight for a long time." So yeah, I guess he plans on being on UFC for a while. Didn't he have a 7-fight contract, right? When he re-signed.
He re-signed and had 10 fights on that contract.
10 fights? And, okay.
Yeah. And that was the first Weidman fight.
Yeah, so he still has a bunch of them left on
his active one.
Six?
Six
or five?
I think it's five.
It's still a lot.
I don't know if this is his sixth or if this is his fifth. So that would be 9, 8, 7, 6, 5. So no, this is fifth fight. So he'll have five more after this one at 208.
Yeah. As long as his leg doesn't break again, he's all good.
Yeah. But that's still two more years. So he is 41. So he'll be fighting till about 43.
Even when he fought DC, he didn't look bad, and he was coming off surgery. So
he beat Bisping, as far as I'm concerned.
Yeah. So in some unfortunate news here, ONE Championship released a news release on Tuesday via Facebook. Casey Swier, a 40-year-old bantamweight from Louisiana, he died in a motorcycle accident in Bali, Indonesia, which is where he was living and training on Sunday. I didn't see too many details. I'm not sure he was the one riding the motorcycle, but it didn't really clarify that. It just said motorcycle mm-hmm. accident. So I'm not exactly sure. But yeah, when you're in a motorcycle and you're in anywhere in Asia, it's not good news. We probably didn't have a helmet either. If I had to guess, he probably did not have a helmet and then probably got hit by a truck. That happens a lot in Asia. It happens here, but in Asia, holy, I would not ride a motorcycle in Asia. That would be the last mode of transportation I would use in Asia. A bike or a motorcycle. Anything with two wheels. Get me away from that thing. I'm not using that. Four wheels with an encasing around me made out of steel. Thank you. I'll use that.
Cars aren't made out of steel anymore.
Well, aluminum. Whatever the hell they're made out of.
Alloy metals. Because they're not really aluminum either.
Whatever is stronger than my skeleton and skin, I'll take it. That sucks. But man, 40 years old, riding a motorcycle, and this guy's just living dangerously. He's like, what's his name? He's like Cowboy Cerrone. He's just asking for it. Eventually,
40 and riding a motorcycle. That's like, and rode that fighting, motorcycle
and
every day
fighting for... in Asia. Man, that shit catches up to you, man. He's riding a motorcycle in Asia, in Indonesia. Okay, I can't imagine those streets being any good.
Well, it depends. If you're in a city, I don't. There'd be too much issue, but.
Well, Bali isn't that? I want to say that's the capital. Indonesia. Indonesia. I'm just, before I look this up, I'm trying to actually think if I can actually Indonesia, because I'm not bad with geography, but okay, let's see. I'm looking this up. Okay, well, Bali looks like it's an island. It's a province of Indonesia. All right. So I don't know what the capital of Indonesia is then. Man, Asian countries are so weird because they're so tiny and they're all like smushed together, and they're all mostly islands except for the really big one, which is China. That's not an island.
Jakarta is the capital.
Oh, hey, cool. Yeah, Jakarta. Yep. I know of that place. I would have never guessed that, though. All right. Did you hear about some new MMA rules that are going to get introduced maybe this summer? It involves replays.
No.
All right. So the association,
I know the ones that just came into effect in 2017.
Okay, yeah. And the ones that aren't even taking effect everywhere, only some places, states that want to do it. Anyways, the Association of Boxing Commissions and Combative Sports Rules and Commissions Committee. Man, that's super fucking. Anyways, ABC. I should have just said ABC. The ABC for MMA has passed the rule of instant replay for fight finishing sequences. So no eye pokes, no nothing else. It has to be a fight finishing thing. So like he can look if maybe, you know, the fight, maybe he didn't see somebody get kicked in the nuts.
Really,
I don't know. What could you think of a fight finishing sequence where you need a replay?
If he tapped would be the only...
I guess if he tapped, yeah, I guess so. Confirmed that he
tapped.
That's
the only thing I can comprehend of that, like, if it was like right at the last second of the round and he's like with 1 second left, did the referee catch it? I don't know, but the fighter might say he tapped. We go to the instant replay. Oh, nope, the round ended. It didn't happen or something. I don't, like, that's the only thing I can
that's
make.
It. Yeah, because you can't really look at replay.
Or if it would be something along the lines of like, considering if it's going to be a no contest or a disqualification.
Oh, yeah. Well, I was going to say, like, unless he missed a fucking knee to the testicles, which is super obvious. But yeah, like, that's the only way that it could. I guess, I guess it would have came into play that last time where the dude did get kneed where he was down, right? And he got knee to the head and it was ruled.
Yeah, but the
fucking
referee called that a no contest.
Yeah, but it should have been a DQ.
This should have, yes. But. Well,
I don't know if a replay would have fixed that.
But again, I would assume that would go to the athletic commissioner of that state. And they would rule that.
I don't know if a replay would have fixed that. Like the ref could have watched that over again and then been like, oh, that's still the same thing. That's what I called it.
Yeah.
Like, so
that was the referee's fault.
Oh,
yeah. Calling it correctly.
Yes. And Invicta, I guess they could have used that replay when she was passed out and been like, hey, look, she's fucking passed out. The fight's done. So I don't know. Like there's very limited times where you would use this anyways.
Yeah.
Yeah. So Paul Gift of Bloody Elbow was the first one to report this, and Sean Wheelock confirmed it on MMA Fighting. Sean Wheelock is the committee chair, apparently. He used to be the announcer of Bellator, and now he does Victory Fighting Championship on Fight Pass, which is interesting. Sean Wheelock, hey, I like him. He did a good job on Bellator.
That is.
He was the...
if I see his face, that might...
He was not the color guy. He was the play-by-play. So he was the one that you heard his voice the most often.
Okay. I've seen his face before.
Yeah. And now it's a new guy. I don't hate the new guy in Bellator necessarily. It's just Sean Wheelock. Powerful. Powerful. He's good. He's a good announcer. So I don't know why they got rid of him, but whatever. He's on a bunch of Fight Pass stuff now.
Why did they get rid of Goldie? Same bullshit.
Yeah, it was new. It was new. House. It was new owners. That's for sure. There's some controversy over the new Nevada Athletic Commissioner right now. There's a new commissioner appointed. It's Stacey Alonzo, and apparently she works for the Fertitta brothers. Yeah. Who still have 8% stake each in UFC. Okay. So combined, they still own 16% of the UFC. They still own 16%.
And then Dana owns 8% or 9% as well.
That's a lot.
The combined is a quarter.
Yeah. So they have no voting power, but man, that's a lot.
Yeah. Between the three of them, that's a quarter. That's a big chunk.
Yeah. That's way more than I would have expected, especially for the Fertittas. Like I felt like the Fertittas maybe just want to get out of it entirely, but 8%. Raking in that money for free now.
And they still got $4 billion and they still have 16%. Wow. Fuck.
It's crazy to me. But so this lady works for them in their casinos. So cool. I don't know what her job is officially. I read the whole thing. This was revealed via their LinkedIn page. This is how people discovered this. They were like, wait a minute. She works for these guys. So just a fun fact right here about the past two. Lorenzo, he used to be on the Nevada Athletic Commission before the UFC could get into Las Vegas. And then
once he
bought the UFC, he's just like, yeah, come on in, guys.
Once he bought it, he did.
Yeah,
push his seat or whatever, but because he knew everyone there.
Yeah, so he made it super easy to me. Yeah.
Yeah.
So, hey, guess what? It's always been corrupt.
Yeah.
So, what can you do? That's not to say that we shouldn't switch it up and that it shouldn't change, but it's been like this for a long time, and I guess people are seeing it more now. And hey, guess what? That's probably another reason why the fucking fighters should unionize.
Yeah, I absolutely think there should be a Fighters Association. Like, I don't.
Yep, just chalk it up there, man, because the reasons are just.
The NFL has one, the NHL has one, the MLB. Like, it's just. That's like, what the fuck? Like, you're talking.
The thing about the NHL, though, and the NBA and all that is, I feel like there's slightly more at stake with them. It's weird. It's weird because it's an individual sport with fighting. So I get why the top dudes would want more money. The top dudes have no problem, right? Like fucking Conor McGregor, fucking Nick Diaz. Yeah. If you can get that money, then you get it. But the bottom dudes deserve more. And the question is, do the top dudes give a shit? And that's the thing about NHL and NBA. Yes, they will give a shit because at the end of the day, everybody's going to make more money. The top guys and the lower end guys, they're all going to make more money. So... the thing about the fighters is they're slowly realizing this. It took a long time, but they're realizing it. And when is that shit going to hit the fan? It's a matter of time.
I think it's going to be fairly soon.
We'll see, man. Within the next two years. It's going to take some really high guys to go in with them. Because if Conor McGregor today goes like, yep, I'm in. What's the best one? Let's figure this shit out. It's gonna take way less time than it is right now. That's for sure. The thing about right now is the UFC is in such an interesting place because they used to have fighters that did favors for them. Hey, yeah, I may be a little bit hurt. I'll fight. Who cares? Yeah, I like you, Dana. I like you, Fertitta brothers. I like you guys. Let's do it. They're not. Nobody's doing that right now. Literally nobody is doing that right now. And another thing is, there's other places they can go. Look at Bellator right now.
That's the thing, is that Bellator cannot fail. If Bellator fails, it's gonna be bad for the sport.
Oh, it's gonna be super hard for Bellator to fail because the people who fucking run it own everything about it. The TV, they own, and they're not overspending. They are not
advertising during when it's on TV. Yeah, then yeah, you fail. Like it's just they're gonna close it down if they're not making money, not losing too. Like it.
I've been impressed with Spike since they bought Bellator.
Yeah, no, it is doing well.
Bellator was on.
It's excellent that it's doing well.
Bellator, they kept it on MTV2 for the longest time before bringing it on to Spike. That was part because the UFC contract said that they had to stay away from MMA for a while. But while it was on MTV2, they developed a super rabid fan base, and they had some really good fighters back then that they still promote now, like Patricky Pitbull is there, who's the guy who just lost to Connor. He lost the belt.
Alves?
Alvarez, yes.
Alvarez, not yes. Alvarez. Yeah.
He was awesome on Bellator back then too, during that transition period. So yeah, I don't see Bellator failing because they have all the numbers. They have all the numbers. I think they control everything.
I guess there's a difference between failing and being competitive.
Yes, sure, yes.
Fair enough. It would be very difficult for them to fail, but they need to show as being very competitive.
I think that they showed that last year, and then now what they need to show this year is that they can put on real cards and are not so much freak showish.
Yeah, like the Kimbo Slice and the Data was it Data
Fight. But those cards were actually really good because they underneath that you had legitimate fights to go along.
Yeah,
with
no,
it.
But I don't mind that fight.
Yeah,
why the fuck was that the main event? To the point Data nearly his heart stopped,
and then Kimbo died.
Yeah, a couple months later or something.
I don't even think it was a month.
I think it was pretty soon after. I don't know.
But it was crazy because Dada was the one fucking on life support. And then all of a sudden, bam, Kimbo Slice is gone too. Huh. All right.
But yeah, doing a freak show would be a good thing. But again, if you get McRory and you get if Edgar goes over or if. Like, there's a couple of really good fighters. Or this guy from the World Series of Fighting goes over to Bellator. It'd probably be fairly.
Yeah, actually, yeah. Justin Gaethje? Is that who you're talking? Oh, David Branch? Sure. David Branch and Justin Gaethje. I don't know what weight class Gaethje is, though. He maybe make more sense in the UFC.
Yeah, I don't. If he's leaving World Series of Fighting, World Series of Fighting is essentially a joke to me.
They weren't until last year for me. They were really close second place with Bellator for the longest time until just Bellator boop took off when they got Scott Coker and all that stuff.
But again, I think Bellator needs a few more fighters that are top fighters. And again, I especially in the featherweight division, I think there's a lot, or even lightweight division, there's all this Conor shit. I think a lot of people are probably pissed off at the UFC, and I could see quite a few of those really good fighters going over to Bellator.
Yeah, and a lot of them
just the bullshit,
and a lot of them with the Adidas contract too. Of them got screwed over on that.
Even get some of the old guys that would then have two or three fights with Bellator and then retire.
Look at Hendo or Henderson. That's one of his reasons why he went to Bellator, right? He said, yeah, I could stay in the UFC, and in the long run, I would probably make more money. But In the short term, yeah. I will just go to Bellator, and this is 100%. I'll make more money just based on me getting sponsors. I'll 100% make more money just based on that. So yeah, in the short term, I'll just go there. So I could see other people doing that too.
Because like I'm thinking, I don't know how many fights he has left on his contract.
Well,
but,
look at this. Bader is going to Bellator right now. It's happening.
Yeah,
it's not official yet, but it's happening. Who's the next? Imagine DC versus Rumble right now. Okay, imagine Rumble fucking gets injured tomorrow.
Yeah,
imagine Bader's the guy. That's the guy you put in the ring with fucking DC next. But he might be going to Bellator.
Yeah,
it's so weird. It's interesting. 2017.
And Bader going over and fighting.
Mr. Wonderful.
What's Wonderful, fucking, like yeah, I got
Phil
Wonderful.
Davis. Phil Davis. Davis.
Phil Davis. Yeah. So having that, like, I would think Bader would crush him because I think he already has.
This would be a rematch.
It would be a rematch. Who won that first fight?
I think
fight?
It was Bader.
I'm clicking on it. My internet's thinking.
I think it was Bader. Unless it was one of those crazy Davis fights where he just finished.
No, he won. He split decision. Yeah, so that actually would be a very good fight for the whole, like...
Well, it would be a fight to sell on Bellator, but would it be a very good fight?
No, it would be a very good promotion, like, to be able to promote that fight, that it was such a close fight this first time. Bader's coming to the Bellator, and he's going to fucking rape ass, but Phil Davis wants revenge.
Yeah, no, it would be a way to sell it, that's for sure. And it's free TV, so you don't even really need to sell it. It's just like, hey, man, these two guys fought, it was... You would think that Phil Davis would win, but no, Bader pulled it off. Can you believe it? Craziness.
Yeah. Yeah. So, Bader's actually, like, I get, like, his last fight was kind of a joke, but...
I cannot believe they're letting him go. I get that they're cutting costs and shit, but this is not the time to let people go to fucking Bellator. It's just not.
Now,
it's
the
just
thing
not.
Is it his choice or that they're, like, they're not...
Oh, it's his choice. They could have matched him. They could have matched Bellator's offer.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah, and they chose not to. So it's still not official, but like everything's done. He just needs to sign, and then we just need to hear about it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Bader's. I guess I don't know what the price tag is. So the UFC's obviously looking at the dollars and cents, but Bader's like ranked four in the light heavyweight. Like he's one of the top guys easily.
And it's somebody that people know. Like, sure, maybe he's not going to be on a pay-per-view main event, but dude, put him on a free fucking Fox card, and that'll sell itself.
Yeah.
But it's hard right now for them, man. I'm telling you, nobody wants to just fight for the UFC just to fight for them. They want to advance their shit. And if it's a fight to not advance their shit, there's not very many people willing to do it right now.
Mm.
Like Souza accepting the fight with Boach, I would say that's Souza being fucking nice. That's way below him. And if he loses that fight, that's terrible.
And again, this is Boach's last fight. He could very likely end up at Bellator.
That's terrible.
If he wins that fight, like, dude, like, just like he just throw his dick down on the table and say, Bellator, give me what I want. Like, what the fuck are you going to say at that point? Like, even, well, the UFC, I don't like, they all obviously have history together or whatever, but. Like, Boach has so much to gain from that fight. Holy fuck.
What was that fastener thing with the UFC? Do you remember? What was that? Dynamic fasteners. Dynamic
fasteners.
That was fastener,
one of the sponsors that
had a lot. Go to Bellator and get that dynamic fastener money.
Well, you'll get sponsor money on your, like, that is just so, like, just with, like, Brandon Schaub goes on about it so fucking much about just the fucking ring looks like a NASCAR, but yet. The guy can't have anything on his shorts.
Yeah,
like,
because everything that was on the shorts is now on the fucking ring.
Yeah,
it's fucking crazy.
And they get, and if you are,
and it's legitimately
on the
same dude,
or something.
It's legitimately the same sponsors. The only sponsor that didn't transfer is Nike. But it's Monster. It's fucking Burger King. It's all the sponsors that the guys used to have.
Well, the guy, they could have whoever the fuck they wanted. It's they went to, like, the, they came to the fighters or whatever, and the fighters said yes, no,
but like,
how much.
Like Burger King sponsored.
Well, yes, because they had, like, they sponsored a lot of people and everything, and now it's just nothing. But
they put a big ass Burger King logo in the middle of the cage.
Yeah. But again, that the UFC is getting that money. The player.
Oh yeah, yeah, no. And, look, from a UFC standpoint, I 100% get why they did that. A million percent get why they did that. But man, from a fighting from the fighter standpoint, it doesn't make any sense for them. All right, the last two news items before we go into UFC Houston here: Stipe Miocic and Junior Dos Santos 2 made official. It's happening in Dallas in May 13th, UFC 211. And then
that's
also
interesting that he's getting that fight without, because he was supposed to fight Struve, but then that fell to shit, and now he's getting a title shot.
And wasn't Kane supposed to fight somebody too, and then that he said that his back was fucked and he couldn't fight that fight?
Yeah, I can't remember who that was though.
Yeah, me neither. was it no, it wasn't Overeem. I don't remember. Anyways, Werdum. Oh, was it Werdum? Yeah, it was Werdum. It was Werdum. It was Werdum versus Kane. Yeah. But yeah, Werdum, whatever you want to call him. He's fighting Rothwell as well on UFC 211, same card. That's stacked with heavyweights right there. That's what co-main event and main event. That's right there. Put that right there. Fucking heavyweights going at it in Dallas. Everything's bigger in Texas. UFC 211. Done deal. Sells itself. It sells itself. These two fights, honestly, pretty awesome. Because I want Werdum to kill Rothwell. And then Stipe Miocic is probably going to win. Probably. I don't want Junior to win, that's for sure.
Junior won their last fight, so
it's going to be interesting. But I could see Stipe winning.
I think Junior won them. Pretty sure Junior won.
No, wait.
Yes.
Yeah.
Junior won.
Okay.
And then he lost against Overeem.
Yeah, I could see Stipe winning. I could see Stipe winning. And this ain't happening in no Brazil either. This is in the good old US of A.
Yeah,
God damn it.
But like, Junior won that fight. The striking was pretty one-sided. Or not one-sided, but lopsided-ish.
Was the first fight in Brazil? I was just assuming that it was.
No, it was in Phoenix.
God damn it. That might as well be god dang Mexico. It's right there. No, I don't know. I'm just talking shit. All right. Let's go to some UFC Houston notes. Before we go on to the results, rating notes here. Fight night headlined by Jung defeating Dennis Bermudez, averaged about 1.158 million viewers. And that's the best number over the last year. So if you go to February of last year during the Super Bowl, it beat that card. And that card was fucking stacked. It had Thompson versus, it was Hendricks. And then it had what the co-main event was. Trying to remember this off the top of my head. I'm honestly surprised I remembered that main event. But that card was fucking stacked last year. And this year, it honestly had fucking Felice Herrig as the co-main event.
Yeah.
Are you fucking... Yeah. What the fuck?
Well, I don't understand that whatsoever. What? Why that? Why the fuck Hill and Andrade were not the co-main event? That would have made so much more fucking sense. Yes. They're the ones in the title contention, and the other two are essentially like...
Well, I think they were expecting...
15 and no one? Like, I
don't... No, well, no, I think they expected Grosso to beat her.
Yeah, but...
she did not.
It made, like, it's ranking-wise, it makes no sense.
Yeah, but they do that often. I can't
obviously
argue with that.
They just
apparently
got a foot in the ass or in the nuts or something like
that. I can't really argue with that now, but like, yeah. So it beat out everything over the last year. So this was the top rated fight night. So that proves that Korean Zombie still draws. People want to see
Korean Zombie. So, He's a fucking axe murderer.
Mm-hmm. So in the history of Fox Sports 1, this is the ninth highest fight night. And then the prelims, headlined by Curtis Blade versus Adam Milstead. That was a pretty good fight, too. Did 834,000 viewers, and that was also the ninth in the ninth top rated
on the fight. Now I'm kind of surprised it got that high.
Yeah, no, this card basically got almost no advertising, and it did really good. And yeah, it was on fucking the Super Bowl weekend, and yeah, usually they put a lot of time and ads and fighters on that card, and they did not do that this year. They had the main event, and then that was it.
Yeah.
So let's go to some results here. The first fight of the night was Daniel Jolie versus Khalil Rountree. And Rountree's a fucking man. That dude is just a beast. And he KO'd him with a knee to the face. Oh, it was so good. And then while he was down on his knees, he kneed him again.
Did he throw a Pokeball at him?
Did he just throw what?
A Pokeball at
him. No.
Looks at it, yeah.
He kneed him. Okay, so he had him in a clinch or the Muay Thai position, I guess, with the head.
A plum. Yeah.
And then he pulled him down, just boom, knee to the face. And he fell down against the cage, kind of. And then he kneed him to the chest just for good measure. Mm-hmm. Just, you know, he didn't need to. It was done. But, you know, why not?
Like, yeah, more people should be doing shit like that. Because you don't necessarily, like, kneeing a guy to the solar plexus. Jesus fucking Christ.
Oh, well, the dude was out, and then he got another knee to the chest just for good measure. Yeah.
But, again, like, hitting somebody in the solar plexus just makes... And you just beat the fuck out of him because he can't breathe. Like, I don't know why more people don't do that.
This was a ridiculous way to start off the card. And then the second fight of the night was a welterweight fight between Alex Morono and Nico Price.
Nico Price looks fucking insanely good.
Oh, he outclassed him. And the fight ended literally at the very last second of the second round. He knocked him out. And the fight ended. And he... And Alex just laid there, and he was like, okay, the fight's done. We're done. It was a spinning back fist. Boom, right to the fucking face. And the dude still looked conscious. It's just he was on the ground, and he couldn't get up. And then it was just like, oh, okay. I guess it's done.
I think he shit himself.
Oh, dude, like, he was like, he fell on top of his legs, and like his legs was like beside his head, kind of. He was just like, on the ground. It's just like, yeah, okay, I guess it's done. So he couldn't get up at the end of the second round. And even the first round was 10-8. I would call the first round 10-8. Nico Price just straight up fucking outclassed him.
He's very impressed. Like, that was his second UFC fight, and holy shit.
Mm-hmm.
Like, shit. Shit. Shit.
How did you watch this if this was on Fight Pass? You don't have Fight Pass.
I didn't. Okay. I saw replays.
Okay, cool. I guess they might have replayed it somewhere. All right.
No, it was YouTube that I saw it on.
Oh, yeah, sure. Highlights. Wherever, highlights, whatever.
Like Price, is, like, fuck. Like, I don't know how they're likely going to bring him up. I think he should take his time.
Mm-hmm.
Like, try to get a top 15 fighter or something like that, opposed to just trying to jump up, because the welterweight division is fucking ridiculous. Mm-hmm. But like, shit.
So the next two fights, I did not watch it. I forget what I did. I think I might have gone dinner or something at this point. But Tisha Torres defeated Beck Rollins. I said that last week. Somebody missed weight in this fight. Beck Rollins came in a little bit heavy. Missed weight by 1.5 pounds. And I'm not surprised that Tisha Torres won. She's a beast. She's a little bit smaller. She could probably go down in weight, but
there is nothing.
That's a problem.
Yeah. Yep. And then, because she was an atom weight.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Because she fought Karate Hottie, I believe, in Invicta at some point in time. But okay, obviously, yeah. If she's good enough to fight at 115 at in the UFC, then that's where you fight, because it's the UFC.
Yeah. And then Ricardo Ramos defeated Michinori Tanaka via unanimous decision.
Yeah.
I did not see this fight, so I can't comment on it. But I do like Tanaka, and I was surprised to see that he lost. Trying to remember if I saw this one. I might have seen the very end of it, but Chaz Skelly defeated Chris Grutzmacher. Oh, yeah, I did see this fight. He got a rear naked choke in the second round, 2 minutes and 1 second. Don't think I watched the whole fight, did you?
I didn't see any of this.
Okay. And but the main event of the preliminary card, Curtis Blade defeated Adam Milstead versus TKO knee injury. So honestly, so here's the thing about this fight. In the first round, what's his name? Let me go back to this page here because I forgot. Adam Milstead.
Milstrom.
Yeah, he injured his knee in the first round. And when he got up to go to his corner at the end of the first round, he was like stretching out his knee and he could barely fucking walk on it. So it was just like he was clearly outmatched in that first round. So that fight probably should have ended after the first round. But then they
I'm looking at his strikes here like Jesus fucking Christ.
It's straight up like Blade is crazy. Like I want to see more of Curtis Blade in the heavyweight division. I guess this is the first time I've seen him, so I have no idea what his potential is. But this fight, he looked really good. Anyways, the second round, he kind of like had him. He was like on his back, kind of, or on his side, and he pulled him down, and his knee like kind of locked into place. So like when he pulled him down, like his knee was still there, but like he pulled him down and then like kind of like just twisted his knee and that's it. Like his knee was gone. Like his knee was already fucked up to that point. But then when that move happened, like you saw his knee, it was gone. So yeah, in retrospect, I'm sure that Milstead would want to just end the fight after the first round.
Like 8 takedowns in like, what the fuck?
Oh, yeah. And that last takedown looked brutal. Like, oh, that knee. Oh, my God. Seeing that kind of stuff is the stuff that I don't want to see, really. Like,
I've done third degree sprains to both my ACLs. I don't want to see that shit. It was like a third degree sprain to my ACL. Like, it was like, I almost popped my ACL. That was just so fucking close to popping. Man, that would have sucked balls. Then like rat dirty testicle balls. Like, shit.
We're on to the main card here. So up to this point, this card has been pretty amazing, except for the two fights that I missed. But even then, I heard that those two fights were pretty okay, too, even though they went to the decision. But anyways, it started off with Jessica Andrade versus Angela Hill. I gotta say though, Hill looked good, but
she can take a punch.
But even when she was taking punches, like she still landed some offense here and there.
Yeah, absolutely.
Like, she stuck into the fight the whole time. It's not like you were there like at the last round being like, ooh, maybe like, whoa, stop this fight because
it wasn't quite because she was always able to circle out correctly. If she got
it, never got to that point. But man, if there was not some rounds that I might have called 10-8. Like Andrade just was at another level. She was landing punches that just looked way more devastating.
Strength was the big difference.
Oh yeah.
The technique was definitely Hill's.
Yes.
But just like
Andrade, when she landed a punch,
Andrade,
it hurt.
Just
it hurt, and you could see that it hurt.
it was just it was just her strength, and then the body shot she was landing on Hill. I think really like that third round, Hill was substantially slower. And it was likely because of the amount of body shots she took.
Well, I don't even remember what round this was, but at one point Angela Hill was backing up so hard that she just kind of like ran into the cage. Like, it was like, whoops, there's a cage there. Whoa.
2 minutes into the second round, if I remember correctly.
Yeah. So, man, Hill was definitely backing up the majority of this fight.
Yes. But Hill did stun Andrade twice pretty well. But it's just she kept moving forward even though she was like double blinking and shit. So
yeah, this is a great fight though.
Yeah,
great fight. That how did this end again? I don't even remember.
Decision.
All right. And then the next fight was a heavyweight fight between Anthony Hamilton and Marcel Fortuna.
This was a really strange fight. Hamilton is substantially larger by, I think, about 50 pounds.
So it was a quick fight, and so there was a head clash very early,
yes,
and there's a cut above the brow that looked very bad. Like, ugh, it looked terrible.
Yeah, it looked really bad.
But it was off to the side, so it wasn't leaking into his eyes. Yeah. But man, ugh, gross.
It was bad, and it was by a headbutt, so yep, that really sucked.
And very soon after, Fortuna got a KO over Hamilton. So, hey. There you go. Fortuna got cut over his eyebrow, and then he fucking got...
Well, he hit him in the temple.
Yeah, yeah.
And his head, Hamilton's head hit the mat before everything else did, so...
It was a crazy looking KO.
Yeah, I don't want to entirely laugh at it, but just the way it happened, it was just like his butt went up and his head went down, and then everything else just kind of followed. It was like that guy got knocked the fuck out.
Yep.
And he like just, it did not look good for Marcel at the beginning, but he hit him right where he needed. Like, dude, that was a good shot. And hell, like, he just was gone. Absolutely fucking gone.
Mm-hmm. And then this fight actually got the top rating of the night. And I think the reason for that is it went the full three rounds. Ovin St. Preux defeated Volkan Ozdemir. Did Ozdemir win? No, wait.
Yes.
Yeah, Ozdemir did win.
He won by decision.
People booed that a lot.
Well, they booed the fight. It was not, that was not a
they did boo
fight.
The fight, but they booed the decision. Nope. They did not agree with the decision.
I did.
I did too, but I could have seen it going the other way. Because that second round was really close, I thought. And then the third round was pretty obvious who won.
It was a very good fight.
Oh, it was not a good fight. It was not a good fight. I'm not saying that at all.
Yeah.
Ovin St. Preux looked good in the first round. That's about it. Or was it the third? No, he looked good in the third round. He looked good in the third round. And Ozdemir looked good in the first. And the second round, you could call it either way, in my opinion.
Yes.
I could easily see it going either way. So,
I feel that Ozdemir, if that's how you...
Ozdemir?
Ozdemir. Yeah. Ozdemir came out like a bat out of fucking hell.
Yep. Oh, yeah. The first 4 minutes of that first round, he looked crazy.
And I think he killed Ovin.
Yeah. He gassed out before that first round was done.
Yeah.
So.
Well, he kind of tried to stay there for the second round. And in the third round, he was just exhausted.
Because he looked really good up until the fourth minute of the first round. And then he started, there was one point where he was chasing him. And then he started taunting with his hands. He was doing something with his hands. And then he got hit right after. And he was like, whoa, okay, maybe I shouldn't do this anymore. And ever since then, Ovin St. Preux hit him in the face. And he was like, okay, maybe I should relax a little bit. And ever since then, the fight was never the same for Ozdemir anyways.
Yeah.
So, I don't have much to say about this fight except that, whatever.
I just felt that St. Preux could have finished him, and he just didn't hit the trigger, was the big thing.
Especially the second round.
He thought he had the rounds, and...
The second round was absolutely... nothing happened. The whole fucking second round was just brutal to watch. That was the bad round to watch. The third round, Ovin St. Preux picked it up a little bit, but it was too late. Like... The second round, I have no problem with the decision because Ozdemir probably did control that second round just because Ovin St. Preux didn't do anything.
Yeah. Yeah.
So, anyways. And then lightweight Abel Trujillo. Jeez, sorry. He always puts on a show against James Vick. This fight was okay.
James Vick looked good.
He looked good. He looked really good. But he went for that submission attempt like three times. And I'm just like,
yes.
Abel, man, he's just done. Especially when he got the choke. Was it in the third round or was it in the second? Third?
Third.
Yeah.
Third.
Yeah. Yeah. Because he was going into for that choke in the second round at the very end there for a few times. And he got out. But he was just too tired at the end that James Vick got it.
Vick looked like was quite solid for all three rounds.
Oh, he looked good on the feet. And when it went down to the ground, it was totally just him. So. Yeah, it was a good fight. And James Vick, I like these two guys. They're always entertaining, so I have no problem with either one of them winning this fight, to be honest. Trujillo, though, he's kind of like, I don't want to say Bigfoot Silva. He's kind of like, He's in Bellator. He also has a lot of tats. I forget. But there's a lot of fighters where sometimes their fights are goddamn insane. And then other fights are just like, eh, man, what happened to this guy? But I don't, James Vick is not one of those dudes. He's always putting on a pretty all right show. Same with Abel Trujillo. So,
yeah.
Like, he lost, but whatever. He'll come back. He'll come back and he'll look good in his next fight, I'm sure. And then the co-main event was, honestly, I did not pay attention to this fight because I don't like Felice Herrig very much.
Yeah.
I'm not a fan of her.
I fast-forwarded through most of it. So I actually watched it, but I turned a 15-minute fight into like 2 minutes.
Sure.
So, and yeah, nothing really happened.
No. Well, I hate Felice Herrig. I'm not a fan of her. I'm as if she won. As if she was on a fucking co-main event during the fucking Super Bowl weekend, and she won.
Yeah.
Man, God, that's all I'm gonna say about that fight. I don't even want to talk about it.
Like, I wouldn't say she looked bad, but she didn't look good.
But it's Felice Herrig. That's not what.
Yeah, I know.
She looked like herself.
Yeah. Well, her striking was significantly better than it has been in the past. Which I think that, like, that she did try striking with her, and she did fairly well striking.
Well, so she called out
was confused.
So she called out Waterson, right? She called out Waterson, yes. Or Paige VanZant after the VanZant fight makes more sense to me.
More sense, yeah, far more sense.
Yeah, because she's coming off of a loss. Waterson should be going either. Even almost for the title or for number one contendership.
I
want
to see Rose and Waterson. Like, dude, that would be an.
Well, yeah, that's the most logical fight to make. Yes, but does that give her number one contendership exactly? I don't know. I don't know about that.
Waterson. Sorry, if Waterson, and Paige, whoever wins that.
No, I don't see. I don't see Rose getting a championship fight if she wins. But I Waterson,
it does
maybe
depend on how it looks like.
I guess so.
Well, I would have to say that Andrade would get the title shot. I think that's already been specified said. And then, like, Paige and Waterson makes it.
Rose.
Sorry, yeah. Well, yeah, Paige. Well, with what Waterson did to Paige, was just fucking hilarious because. What the hell did you expect to happen?
Well, it's just it's the same thing with the co-main event in that event, on that Fox event. A lot of people thought that what's his name, Pretty Gall. Boy, would beat.
If Gall,
but
couldn't finish him in the first round, I gave Sage a fair bit more of a chance.
I was pretty confident that Gall would win that.
But. Well, just Sage is just not good enough on the ground. He needs just to do a fucking fucking jujitsu.
I'm a huge fan of Sage. I love Sage. It's just he got brought up to the UFC way too early. He makes way too much money. It's so subjective, right? He deserves the money he makes, but everybody else deserves more money than he makes. Is the thing. Right, he deserves it. I'm not gonna give him any shit because he 100%. But man, if he deserves that money, everybody else
Gall looked like shit in that second round, and he still got Northcutt into the rear naked.
Did he look like shit? I don't
absolutely
know.
Exhausted.
Oh, he was exhausted, but he was still able to get him to the ground and get what he wanted.
But if it was anyone other than Sage Northcutt, I don't think he would have won that.
It was like Stone Cold getting pile drove on his head and still getting the pin, man. He still did it.
Like, if he was actually fighting someone who had some sort of jiu-jitsu skill, he was not
fight. I 100% agree with you, but that's why...
I'm not even talking about Brazilian jiu-jitsu.
That's why I think that he's... I love Northcutt, but he's way above his pay grade.
Both of them are going back down to lightweight. Or I guess Gall is now going to lightweight, and Sage is going back down.
I had no idea about Gall.
In the interview, he was saying he was going to go down to lightweight after that fight.
He called out Hardy.
Which was likely be at lightweight.
Whatever. Okay, sure.
Because I don't think Hardy's large enough to compete with the welterweights now.
I'll disagree. All right, let's talk about this main event. I honestly thought it was topped a little bit early. Korean Zombie won. He landed a pretty hard uppercut that got Bermudez down. I don't really think that Bermudez got a chance to defend himself.
Because he took three punches without defending himself, so he
did. On the ground?
Himself. Yes. He took three shots before the referee stepped in.
I'm not going to 100% disagree with it. I was not opposed to it, but I do think it could have went on a tiny little bit longer. That's all I'm saying.
Well, Bermudez grabbed the referee's leg and tried taking him down.
I don't think it was that aggressive.
He grabbed his leg and started wrestling his leg.
All right, then. Sure.
Like, I'm pretty sure that was over.
Hey, look. Look. I am a big Korean Zombie fan, so I'm biased towards his side. I do think it could have went a little tiny bit longer.
I entirely disagree, but I don't.
I see your point 100%. I 100% agree with you, and I don't disagree with the stoppage, but I don't disagree with Bermudez wanting to go a little bit longer either.
Fair enough. Fair enough.
And there's been
the referee is doing
his
job, is the way he saw it, is that it was
There's been more. But, let's just say there's been more brutal knockouts that have been allowed to keep going, like Pat Barry versus fucking what was it? Who is him? He's in Bellator 2 now. The big black guy, French black guy.
Congo.
Yeah, Congo. No. Yeah, Czech Congo. It was Czech Congo. It was totally Czech Congo. Okay. Oh my God! Both of them in that fight were out. Both, they could have been stopped two times for fucking either side, and it didn't. And then Pat Barry, that fight was brutal. Honestly, if you want to see a fight that had some bad decisions in terms of ref stoppages, that I think that's the worst.
Mm.
That could have been stopped multiple times. And just, what the fuck is going on? Like, I get that it's Czech Congo and Pat Barry, and maybe, hey, they're heavyweights and they're stronger and they're tougher. But what the fuck? Like, this is crazy. Yeah. That fight was brutal. But this was not one of those fights. And I love Korean Zombie. I'm so happy he won. But where do you go with him from here? I don't know. What's his next fight? I can't think of anything right now.
Pettis is going back up, so that's not making any sense. Actually, that would make a lot of sense.
Oh, something funny that I heard.
Herrera Rodriguez.
Oh, yeah, sure.
They're 8-9, but that would just be like a really interesting fight.
Yeah, I could see that.
Or Oliveira would make kind of sense, too.
I heard a funny story. So Brian Stan was the one announcing this event, and yes. he goes up to every fighter personally, right, and asks them how to pronounce their name. And he was like, he went up to Chan Sung Jung, and he's like, "How do I pronounce your name?" He's like, "Korean Zombie."
The zombie, yeah.
Yeah. Korean Zombie. and that makes sense, like 100%. That's why I know him. Like, I know his name. Chan Sung Jung is out of all of the Korean names I could think of, he kind of has a catchy name because it kind of rhymes and it goes together well. But like, yeah, no, Korean Zombie.
No, he's just Zombie.
Yep, that's the way to do it.
He wants me to call him Zombie. It's just weird. I don't
That was funny though. Overall, though, it was a short 2 minutes, but it was an intense 2 minutes that I enjoyed the whole time.
Well, because, Bermudez, Zombie took a pretty good shot. Yeah, and it was I'm in a fight. Okay, let's do this.
Like, Bermudez did not necessarily look bad in this fight.
No. Zombie took that first shot, and he's like, whoa, okay, yeah. I am in a fight. Okay, it's been 3.5 years. It's been a while.
It's just Bermudez got fucking uppercutted right in the face, and, it was just that shot. Like, what else can you do, man?
And I don't think Bermudez saw that coming in. Like, the way he was coming in, it hit and just, I think he was looking up trying to do an overhand right or something like that was what was happening, and it just came in underneath.
Oh yeah, no, he landed that flush right down the middle. And did he land a left hook right after? Because there was a right uppercut.
I want to say yes. Yeah. I think it was a glancing shot because he was falling as he hit. Yeah. But it did connect. And then he hit with two or three on the ground before the ref was able to get there.
Honestly, the only reason why the Ovin St. Preux fight was the top rated fight is because this one lasted like 50 seconds. Is that what it was?
It was a little longer than that.
52? Oh, 2 minutes and 49 seconds.
Yeah. It was like half a round.
Yeah, so usually the top drawing main events is the ones that go into the fourth and fifth rounds. People are like, oh, we're going to tune in late to this thing. Like, honestly, that's what happens with the free events anyways. Because it always goes over 10 p.m., right? And then people fucking go, oh, hey, look, there's still UFC on. Let's watch this main event going on. That happens a lot. And even the Paige VanZant and Michelle Waterson fight underdelivered a little bit because it went on so short. It was 2 minutes. If that fight would have went on fucking three rounds, that the number for that event would have been way higher. But it still did okay on Fox. So, yeah, that's it. Is there a UFC this weekend? No. Yeah, no.
Is it this weekend or next weekend? I think this weekend.
I'm going to go back.
208.
208, home versus the Rams. Yeah, that's this weekend.
It's the 11th. Yeah, it's the 11th.
We might as well talk about that. The only real fight. Well, I guess there's two fights to look forward to. Oh, man, three fights. There's three fights. Jim Miller is on the beginning of the main card. That's all right. So there's Anderson
Glover's fighting some big black dude Glover. That I've never heard of.
Who fucking cares? I hope he loses.
Probably will.
While Holly Holm and Jermaine Durandamy is fighting for some worthless women's featherweight title. And it's even more worthless now because fucking Cyborg can't fight for it. So who cares? Like, honestly, it's just another title. They should have went the other way with it, but it's a shame. It's a shame that she had to fuck all of it up. Way to go, Cyborg. Anderson Silva is against Derek Bronson. Honestly, I'm kind of intrigued by this.
Yes.
Normally, I would think Anderson Silva would destroy him, right? But which Anderson Silva is this? I don't know.
Wait, he looked pretty good in the Bisping fight. He looked pretty good in the Cormier fight. So, it comes down to how he plays it, I think, more so than anything. Does he go back to his old ways and going like...
I doubt it.
Or is he actually going to go in there and...
Yeah, and he can't afford to do that against Derek Bronson and get fucking knocked out.
Right, and that's the thing. Like, if he does that against Bronson, there's a good chance he's going to get knocked the fuck out.
I would probably bet for Silva, but it's such a fucking close
fight. I would
not
be surprised if Bronson was able to do it. Now, it's how. Do you think you get knocked? Like, do you think this is going to be finished, or is it going to go the distance?
I don't see it going the distance, to be honest. And if it does, it's probably just going to be Silva fucking grinding it out.
Like, grinding it out or counterpunching it out?
A little bit of both. Because I don't see him fucking standing for fucking 5 minutes in a round against Bronson.
But I don't think he could really take him down. His wrestling's not that great. His jiu-jitsu's pretty good, but his wrestling's not that great.
He could just clinch and do a bunch of stuff. Like, there's like, a lot of stuff that's...
Like, he'd be doing his Muay Thai shit and trying to knee him in the head.
Yeah. It's an interesting fight because I don't know how they're going to clash.
I
have no idea. This could be a super boring fight or a super entertaining fight.
It'd be an awesome fight, yes.
Yep.
The MMA math on this is very intriguing.
And then Ronaldo Souza versus Tim Boach. Again, this is a pretty easy one to pick, but it could...
I want Boach to win.
Oh, I don't... No, don't say that. Oh, God, no.
I don't like Souza all that much.
I love Souza. He's one of the few Strikeforce dudes that I'm behind. Souza's awesome. Oh my God, his UFC career, he's just gotten such a crapshoot of luck. It sucks because he could easily be the champion right now. He could.
Well, yes, but then he'd be fighting Romero and getting his ass raped.
I would argue that Souza is one of the few guys that would not get totally destroyed. He would get destroyed, just not totally destroyed.
Okay, maybe.
Because Souza could take him down and try to fucking take
silver
away
silver medalist in the Olympics.
Yes, but you got it's different. It's not the same. It's not the same.
This no, it's MMA. Not. There's knees and elbows that he can be freaking Romero will be throwing at him and breaking his head open.
Sousa's a tough dude. That's all I can say. I want Sousa to win. It would be stupid for fucking Bosch to win. I just, God damn it, no. And we brought up Glover Teixeira.
He lost to Rockhold, though, so I don't entirely...
Yeah, but Rockhold was the champion, and then Bisping,
no.
And...
No.
Well, he was... No, I'm saying... No, he wasn't the champion then. I'm saying he did. He was
the
champion.
Yeah, well, so I don't, like... The big thing is, yes, Sosa's improved his striking significantly, but, like, Rockhold was still able to beat him back then, so I don't... Like, it's just, who has he fought? Like, he fought Vitor... He lost to Romero in a controversial split decision. That was before Romero figured out how to actually fight properly. Because he always burnt his...
Oh, dude, he has one loss in his fucking record since Rockhold. Give me a break.
Yeah, but look who he's fighting.
Give me a break. Gegard Mousasi? Is that who you're pointing out? It's pretty all right.
Chris Camaro, is he?
Vitor Belfort?
Who is he fighting?
Oh, I'm saying that he should get a shot. Anyways.
Chris Camozzi. Why is he fighting Chris Camozzi?
Because there's fucking no one else.
Why is he fighting no one? Like, he should be asking for the top fights.
He should. Yes, he should. There you go. I agree with you. He should be fucking...
But he's not.
No, because they're not giving them anybody else.
That's bullshit. If he was on Dana White's balls saying, I want this fight.
He should.
Dana would give him the fight.
He should be.
He's not. So that's the whole point, is that he's scared shitless.
He's not scared shitless. Give me a break.
Or he knows he's going to lose.
Glover Teixeira, anyways, he's in the next fight against Jared Cannonier. Sure. I don't really know that dude. And then Dustin Poirier versus Jim Miller in the opening fight of the pay-per-view. Yeah. That's okay. Opening fight.
Miller's not ranked.
Who did he lose against last fight? Was it
he beat Lozon.
No, but who did he lose to?
Alves. Thiago.
Oh, Sanchez and Michael Chit. My God, yeah, rank that dude. What's going on?
Well, he lost to Sanchez.
Yeah, but that was a long time ago, man. March 2016. That's almost a year now.
Year ish, yeah.
He's fucking.
And then
fought
he's won three
times.
Straight. And then, yeah, I don't understand why he's not ranked.
Yeah, and then he's gonna be ranked if he beats Poirier. That's for sure.
Yeah.
All right, that's the main card.
I guess. Well, but like he destroyed Alves, though.
Are you looking at the preliminary card right now?
No, I was looking at Miller's record.
Oh, okay. So there's a few notable fights here on the Fight Pass card. Philippe Nover is fighting Rick Glenn. I have no idea who Rick Glenn is, but Philippe Nover is fucking a badass. So that's a really great starting fight right there. Ryan LaFleur, he's all right. Versus Roan Canero. He's actually pretty good too, so I might... That might be the sleeper pick right there of the night. That might be a really good fight that people might not be expecting to be a great fight. And then,
well, E. McCall versus Brooks actually looks like a pretty good fight, too.
Yeah, well, Jared Brooks. I have no idea who Jared Brooks is.
Yeah.
I know enough. Of fighters who are called Brooks.
Yeah.
But
I know the name Brooks is kind of what I'm...
Yeah, Brooks, what's his name?
First fight in the UFC.
He's fighting in Japan now. What's his fucking name? He has long blonde hair, right? Is that who you're thinking of?
I can't picture. This guy's 12-0, so he's not.
Will Brooks. Is that who I'm thinking of?
Yeah, Will Brooks. That I know the name. I can't picture the face.
Oh, though. Yeah. Okay, yeah. So, yeah, he was in USC for a little bit. Now he's in Japan. That's the last time I saw him. Anyways. Ian McCall, yeah, that's a good fight. Nick Lentz versus Islam Makhachev, sure. Nick Lentz is all right. And then
Russian versus Lentz.
The the main event of the preliminary card, Randy Brown versus Belal Muhammad. I'm not entirely sure who Brown is, but Belal is fucking crazy. The
last fight I remember, Jamaican, he knocked the fuck somebody out.
Jamaican American mixed martial artist.
No, he lost his last.
Randy Brown.
He got knocked the fuck out.
So check this out. So this freaking Randy Brown dude, he's a Jamaican American. His last two fights, he beat Brian Camozzi versus Brian Camozzi via TKO knees and punches, and then Eric Montano versus via guillotine choke. He only has one loss on his record, and then all of his wins except for one are via KO or submission or TKO. So I'm not super familiar with this guy. I don't recognize him by name, but Jesus, his record is scary.
Submission, yeah. Well, he lost to a submission second round from
Michael Groves. Graves.
Great. I don't remember these fights. I don't really know who Brian Camozzi is.
Well, I know who Brian Camozzi is, but
I know Chris Camozzi.
Oh, that was the New York card before the brothers. Yeah, that was the New York card before the Toronto card. That card was really good. I remember fucking loving that card. It was so underwhelming on paper, but holy fuck, that card was really good. Was his fight on the main card? Oh no, Randy.
No,
Brown. No.
TKO. It was the early prelims, right? It was the co-main event, I guess, of the early prelims.
Yep. Either way, and then that's it. That's the preview for UFC 211, or sorry, 208. I'm getting ahead of myself here. That's a lot of fights. That's happening in New York. Think about it. That's happening in New York, and the card is fucking nothing.
So?
This is like, it's in New York. It's at the Barclays Center. That's
exactly
a big arena. That's a big arena, dude. That's where the fucking...
Yeah, you know why it's booked there? Because it was originally supposed to be Cyborg.
No, that's what they wanted.
Yeah, I know, but that's like they booked this...
Oh, yeah, but it was never actually her.
I know, but they booked it thinking it was going to be her, and then she's like, no, and then...
Oh, no, this card has been... I want to say this card has been announced since the first New York card they did. They announced this a long time ago. They had time to fucking put a card for this fucking event if they wanted to. The problem is that who's gonna fight now? Like all the champions fought recently. Conor McGregor doesn't give a shit. Like who's gonna fight? No one. You don't have anybody right now.
Well, they have a lot of shit scheduled, so it's kind of.
Yeah, now, but a lot of that stuff got scheduled after, man. Like, I don't know. They like could have
the Halifax fight, which is now Lewis versus Brown,
and the Buffalo fight with DC and Cormier. That could have been in New York.
It is in New York.
Well, Buffalo is in Buffalo, New York. But I mean, like New York proper. Like this is in New York, like New York City. It's in the suburb. It's not New York exactly city. I think it's in Queens. Where the fuck did the Nets play? Brooklyn. They play in Brooklyn, so it's technically in Brooklyn, but it's
like 209 looks pretty good.
Oh no, I'm not gonna be here and shit on all the cards. the Buffalo card looks really good. The 211, man, the Dallas card, fucking the two heavyweights, the two co heavyweight main events, fucking. I'm looking forward to that. I don't even care what the rest of the card is. It's probably going to be good, but those two main events alone, JDS and Stipe and Verdum and Boach, this should be good. And yeah, 211, so 209 looks good for hardcores. But who's actually... Oh, 209. That's it. Oh, that's in fucking Brooklyn too. No, wait. What? So they've been switching everything around. So wait, where is home versus Oh, it's in New York.
209 is in Vegas.
They're both in New York. Crazy. Okay, so Home versus the Random E is in New York, Barclays Center.
Is in Brooklyn, yeah.
Yeah, and then 209 is in Brooklyn too. No, wait.
No, 209 is in Vegas. 209
was supposed to be in Brooklyn. God damn it. Yeah, no, they pushed everything over. Yeah, 209 was supposed to be in Brooklyn. But 208 was supposed to be in Anaheim. They canceled that. Everything got pushed over. Okay, God, that scared me. All right, okay, this is in Vegas. That makes more sense. Yeah, Alistair Overeem and Mark Hunt's fucking crazy fight.
Yeah, like 209.
Mark Hunt is actively suing the UFC, and yet he's still fighting for them. That's fighting. Cool. You know what? I'll talk about the Royal Rumble real quick, because I don't think I did. The Royal Rumble's pretty good this year.
You talked about it slightly, about...
Oh, did I?
Brock getting beaten the fuck out by Goldberg. Oh, yeah,
that is right. I was... Okay, so I'm slightly disappointed by who won. I don't really care about Randy Orton winning. And then this week, they gave away Randy Orton versus John Cena, which is supposedly going to be the main event of WrestleMania, right? Because Orton is the number one contender and Cena's the champion right now. That kind of made it obvious that fucking Cena's not going to be the champion by WrestleMania. Because why would they give away the fucking fight right now? Right after fucking Royal Rumble.
So, Cena's the champion now.
Yes. Yes.
But he's supposed to be...
No,
is that not what
but
you
Randy
get
Orton
for
run,
winning the Rumble?
No. Randy Orton won the Royal Rumble. So he will be at WrestleMania.
Right.
So they already fought at SmackDown this Tuesday. So what I'm saying is John Cena is probably going to lose a championship between now and WrestleMania. So Randy Orton is not going to be against John Cena at Mania. It's going to be whoever wins the title off of Cena.
I thought you just said it was Cena versus Orton at WrestleMania.
No. They already fought this Tuesday.
Oh, so it won't. Okay.
Yeah, so I'm saying it won't be that, because why the fuck would they give that away right now? So I'm saying that John Cena is going to lose a title to somebody. And then whoever beats John Cena.
Was that for the belt on?
It was for the belt, but John Cena won. Yeah, so the only thing I can say about the Royal Rumble is I was sad that there was not that many surprises. Like, number 10 was the one surprise that we got, but we knew who the fuck it was going to be. So who cares? It wasn't really a surprise. So it's not like Samoa Joe or somebody came up. There was no surprises, literally no surprises. And all of the big guys, Undertaker, Goldberg, Brock Lesnar, they were all stacked
at the end.
There's like Brock Lesnar should have came out earlier and fucking thrown out more people. And then Goldberg should have came out at 26, sure, why not? And then throw out fucking Goldberg, or Lesnar, sorry. But Lesnar threw out like maybe two or three guys. Like he did not look that impressive. He came out, threw out a couple guys. Goldberg came out, bam, he's out. And then right after, bam, Undertaker takes out Goldberg. And I'm underwhelmed that Undertaker took out Goldberg too, because fucking Undertaker's super old. He can't really do shit. Not that Goldberg is not old either, but he can do more than fucking Taker.
Well,
he
can move. Goldberg's still big motherfucker, so there's some plausibility of him doing something.
Mm-hmm. Undertaker's just super old now, and he's getting towards the end where maybe he can't do WrestleMania anymore. It might be getting to that point.
I just think, like, he was like 27 when he debuted as the Undertaker in like 93. So it's been 23 years.
Before that. It was like 88 or something that he debuted as The Undertaker. 89?
No, we went over that last week.
Oh, God damn it. I'm looking.
93.
God damn it. No, I'm 100% sure that it's not 93. Because Ric Flair came into WWF in 92, and Undertaker was already a character. Maybe it was 92? But I want to say he started in the 80s when it was dumb still. So he signed with WWF in 90. Let's see.
Because he was part of the Skyscraper where he replaced Sid Vicious in 90. And that would have been on WCW.
Calloway made his WWF debut as Kane the... Oh, you talked about this. Kane the Undertaker at a taping of Superstars on November 19th,
91. Yeah, November. Okay.
Yeah.
So 90. Okay, so it's been 26 years. And he was born in 65. So yeah, he's 51.
Oh, he's old. There's a few matches that he had with Brock Lesnar where he looked really good, but then when he had his Brock Lesnar match at WrestleMania, supposedly he had a concussion, and that match was terrible. That match was so bad. But there's some other matches with Brock Lesnar he had lately, which was pretty good. Either way, yeah, the Royal Rumble was really good. The AJ Styles versus John Cena match was very good. I think I liked the Kevin Owens versus Roman Reigns match more. I seem to be in the minority with that, though. Because everything about that match was really good. I like the ending. I like how Y2J got involved. I like how Braun Strowman got involved in that match, too. Everything about that match was really good. It set up a bunch of stuff later on that I'm not opposed to. What's his name? Roman Reigns. He's whatever, but Roman's he's fine. People hate him for no reason. I find he doesn't deserve the championship belt, and hey, guess what? He doesn't have it. So people get their wish and stop booing him now. He's where he belongs. He doesn't need the belt. Just keep him below that level, and yeah, he should do fine. Against Braun Strowman in a one-on-one match, though, for 10, 15 minutes, however long that match is going to last. It's probably not going to be very good, but hey, whatever. Anyways, I don't know. That's all I have to say about the Royal Rumble.
And I got nothing to say about the Royal Rumble because I don't watch the soap operas.
Well, but the Royal Rumble is real. It's the one match a year where it's real. They're okay. Fighting... for a chance at WrestleMania, man. How could it not be real? They're going for the WWE title, man.
Exactly my point.
All right. Well, thanks for tuning in. We're here every Thursday talking about MMA. Megasearcher.com. That's where you can go to check out all our VODs and MP3s. Wherever you can find podcasts, go there as well. iTunes. You know, podcatchers on your Android devices and all that. YouTube.com/MegaScorcherTV is where you can go find us. Like and subscribe to our channel. We got a bunch of videos, old schools, what else? You know, other stuff. That's about it, though. You got anything else to add?
I'm right. Done.
If you're watching live, stay tuned. We'll still be here. See ya.
See ya.